Hi everyone, today we are going to talk about our project, Efficient Multi-Task Auxiliary Learning, Selecting Auxiliary Data by Feature Similarity. The authors are Gongbo Nian, Chen Yicheng, Ying Shengxiang, Yang Zexuan, Chen Yunong, and we are from National Taiwan University. Here is the outline of the presentation. First, we will start at the background and the motivation, and we will talk about our methods, and finally, the experiments and the conclusion. And we are going to start from the background. What is multi-task auxiliary learning? So here is a simple demonstration of the difference between multi-task learning and multi-task auxiliary learning. In multi-task learning, the octopus, which is the model, needs to learn all the tasks and evaluate on each of them. However, in multi-task auxiliary learning, though the model also learns multiple tasks, it only evaluates on the primary task, which is the red book in the image. The other gray books are simply supplementary materials to help the model perform better on the primary task. This technique is extremely useful when the primary task has a small dataset. Using auxiliary data will more likely to benefit the performance. Now let's look at the development of multi-task learning. Start from MTDN, it is seen that the number of tasks and data sets are getting larger and larger. Furthermore, in the near future, more and more NLP tests or even multimodal tests will be released. The scale and power of multi-task learning will only get larger. This trend is also reflected on multi-task auxiliary learning. When we want to improve a primary task, using more and more auxiliary tests will be a great and easy way. Now let's talk about the multi-task auxiliary learning. Why multi-task auxiliary learning is inefficient. Using more auxiliary data seems promising to improve performance. However, the increasing of computing costs cannot be ignored. For example, when we compare the single task scenario and multi-task auxiliary learning scenario using RTE as the primary task, the training cost is 400 times larger in MTDN settings and 2000 times larger in MAPPED settings. The computing cost is obviously too high, and multi-task learning on such large scale is impractical. In this slide, we demonstrate a standard process of multi-task auxiliary learning. Usually it includes two stages, a multi-task learning stage to jointly learn from multiple tasks and a fine-tuning stage to further tune the model on the primary task. And the reason why multi-task auxiliary learning is inefficient is because of the huge size of the auxiliary data. So to fix the efficiency problem, we sought to use less auxiliary data. So the first question here is, are all auxiliary data beneficial? Because if there are unuseful auxiliary data, we may be able to eliminate them and shrink the size of the auxiliary data. So we conduct an experiment on glue dataset. We multi-task auxiliary learning using each task as a primary task and other as auxiliary tasks. The results shows that for each primary task, the usefulness of the auxiliary data might be different. For SST2 and COLA, the performance even dropped when training with auxiliary data. And this is called negative transfer. Since not all auxiliary data are beneficial, we are going to shrink the size of it. And thus we propose a two-stage multi-task auxiliary learning with a data sampling method. Before we do a multi-task auxiliary learning, we are going to use the sampling method in the first stage to shrink the size of the auxiliary data. Thus, the computing cost of training auxiliary data can be reduced. So, which data sampling method to use? Actually, a more similar prior work have proposed a method to automatically decide the using task and missing ratio of all auxiliary tasks. This method can successfully avoid negative transfer and further improve the performance. Also, it can reduce auxiliary data size. However, it cannot reduce the computing cost. But why? This is because their sampling method itself is computationally expensive. The reason why the sampling method itself is computationally expensive is that in the prior work, they actually need to train through all the data multiple turns to be able to decide the mixing ratio of auxiliary tasks. This will cost more time than to directly train on all of the auxiliary data. Thus, for our target sampling method, we're limited to only be able to run through all of three data in predicting times and in a single turn. So how do we sample data efficiently? We cannot train through all the data, so we need to decide whether to use the data only by its property. Thus, we propose the idea of feature similarity. We make an assumption that more similar is S3 data to a primary task, more benefit it can make. This assumption is also default in most of the multi-task learning projects that people will multi-task training multiple relative tasks together. We use a figure to demonstrate our idea. Basically, when some auxiliary data, those green points, is more beneficial, we assume that they will be more similar, which is closer to the pseudo-centroid of the primary task, compared to those unhelpful red points data. To further confirm our assumption, we conduct a toy experiment. We multitask training 500 data from each school task and visualize its feature using TSNE. In the figure, it is seen that the scatter points from MMLI, RTE, MRPC, and STSB have more overlap than others. This corresponds to their performance improvement when doing multitask auxiliary learning. The task with more similar auxiliary data can improve the most. Based on the previous investigation, we think that feature similarity can be a great indication for the usefulness of auxiliary data. So the next question is, how do we get the rank of feature similarity? We decide to train a small proxy model with test discriminating objective and use the test discriminating score as the similarity score. So first, we multitask training a proxy model with original test and an additional test discriminating objective using a small mixed set of all tests. After training the model, we use the test discriminator to predict the similarity score of each data to the primary task, and further select the top-ranked data. The predicted score indicates the similarity between an auxiliary data and the primary task. Higher is the similarity score, more possible it can benefit the primary task. By doing this, we are able to shrink the size of the auxiliary data and using only the most useful ones. So here's the overview of the two-stage multi-task auxiliary learning pipeline. In the first stage, we use the feature similarity to select the most useful auxiliary data, and further use them in the second stage to perform multi-task auxiliary learning. Now we're going to talk about our experiments. We conduct the experiment with a setting similar to MTDNN. The dataset is school benchmark, and the model we use is BERT-based. The first baseline is no MTL, which is single test fine-tuning. The second baseline is random sampling, which simply randomly sample data from auxiliary data. The random sampling is a surprisingly strong baseline, which is also mentioned in other papers. The third baseline is fully trained, which will multitask learning all auxiliary data. This is a strong baseline and an assumed upper bound, which is inefficient since it needs to train through all the auxiliary data. For the evaluation, we only evaluate the performance on RTE, MRPC, and STSB. Since they are improved by MTL, so we can make sure that there exists useful auxiliary data for us to select. Here is a demonstration of our experiment. For the fully trained, we simply multitask auxiliary learning on all auxiliary data. After training, we further fine-tune the model on the primary task and evaluate the results. For random sampling and similarity sampling, we will do a sampling method before multi-task auxiliary learning. Here we show the results of our experiment on RTE and MRPC. Our methods achieve highest scores on both tasks. We also achieve the best score on STSB. Our proposed method can outperform random sampling and even surpass the fully trained model. This means that our method can use less data and computing time to achieve better performance. Here we further show the time efficiency of our method. Using our method, we can surpass fully trained model using only 50%, 60%, and 0.05% data. Also, when we compare the time efficiency on SDSB, our method can outperform fully trained model 12 times faster. Now we will conclude our work. There are three main contributions in our work. Firstly, we address the importance of efficiency in multitask auxiliary learning. Secondly, we propose a data sampling method to shrink the size of auxiliary data and successfully reduce the computing cost. Thirdly, we propose to use feature similarity to determine the data usefulness, and the experiment results shows the effectiveness of our method. We are able to surpass fully trained model using less data and computing time. Finally, we are the first work focusing on the efficiency of multitask auxiliary learning. So if you are interested in our work, welcome to visit our GitHub page. Thanks for listening. If you have any question, welcome to contact us. Also, we will attend a poster session in the conference. So welcome to find us and discuss.